Everyone generates hazardous waste. From the industries that build our computers to the farms that feed us, hazardous waste is created through our everyday activities. And when not managed safely, it poses dangerous health risks. Before the 1970s, the management of hazardous waste was inadequate, resulting in dumping in waterways and unused plots of land. In 1976, Congress passed the Resource Conservation and Recovery Act, or RCRA, which provided a framework for the safe management of hazardous waste across the U.S. California is at the forefront of environmental protection, with some of the most robust environmental regulations in the nation. The California Department of Toxic Substances Control employs qualified and passionate professionals to implement RCRA and state laws. DTSC's Hazardous Waste Management Program oversees permitting, enforcement, and policy development. The Permitting Division works to protect all people, communities, and the environment by implementing hazardous waste laws through timely, technically sound, and enforceable permit decisions. Now, the permitting team is going to walk you through the five phases of DTSC's application and decision-making process.
A hazardous waste permit is usually active for 10 years after its approval. A complete application must be submitted before expiration to continue operating.
Starting on January 1st, 2025, a permit application must be submitted 2 years before the permit expires. A reminder letter will be sent out 3 years before the permit expires,
notifying the facility to begin the process of renewing their permit.
Thanks, Melanie. During the pre-application phase, our team meets with the facility to discuss its operations and provide guidance on submitting a properly complete permit application. We discuss hazardous waste units, environmental monitoring, and any other site-specific factors that may affect the review of the permit application. A strong pre-application phase will ensure the application is completed properly, reducing the time and costs associated with the review.
Thanks, Sean. The applicant then submits the permit application, which initiates the review phase. The first part of the review phase is the administrative review. This review takes about 30 days and focuses on administrative completeness to ensure all required sections are included. Next, the technical review phase begins. We review engineering design, calculate seismic stabilities, analyze possible chemical emissions, identify possible contamination to groundwater, examine operating procedures, and direct applicants to change the proposed operations so they are more protective. This is the longest part of the permitting process. We aim to complete the technical review for each permit in 13 months or less. Any issues are summarized in a letter we call a Notice of Deficiency, or NOD, and multiple NODs may be issued. After all issues have been addressed, the technical review is complete, and we move on to the next phase.
Thanks, Parampreet. Once we have a complete understanding of an applicant's operations and review the findings of our technical experts, we propose a draft permit decision to issue a permit or deny the application. The draft permit describes each of the hazardous waste management units and establishes conditions. Permit conditions ensure that ongoing operations are protected. These include provisions like maximum capacities, environmental monitoring, periodic reporting, and other requirements beyond regulations that protect the public and the environment. Once the draft permit decision is ready, public engagement begins. We share the draft permit decision with the surrounding community and interested parties so they can comment on the proposed decision. To get the word out, we use newspapers, radio ads, mailings, social media, and the department's website. We also hold public meetings to share information, explain the basis of permit conditions, answer questions, and to give the public an opportunity to voice concerns.
Thanks, Omar. We take all comments into account when determining if the proposed decision should be finalized or changed. If the decision to issue a permit is finalized, the permit is issued along with a public notice and a response to all comments submitted to DTSC. We give anyone who submits a comment the opportunity to review our response to their feedback and appeal the decision before putting it into effect. A final permit is typically for a 10-year duration. DTSC continues to monitor the facility compliance and environmental protections put in place by the permit.
Thank you, Karen. We embrace a culture of continuous improvement, and we're always looking for ways to make the permitting process more effective and efficient. We're also working on ways to make it easier and more meaningful for the public to engage with us. If you'd like to offer suggestions on how we can improve the permitting process or to learn more about permitting, please give us a call or visit us on our website.